ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜிய திருவடிகளே சரணம் ஜிய திருவடிகளே சரணம் வி ஆர் கோயிங் த்ரூ சம் ஆஃப் தி ஃபண்டமெண்டல் ஆஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் அவர் ஸ்ரீ வைஷ்ணவ சம்பிரதாயம் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு அவர் டெய்லி அனுஷ்டானம்ஸ் ப்ரீவியஸ்லி வி சா அபவுட் தி ருட்டீன் ஆஃப் வேக்கிங் அப் How to wake up in the morning. Waking up with the meditation on Guru Parampara. Meditating upon the Rahasya Trayam with their meanings. Meditating upon Sriman Narayana, Hari, Vishnu were all highlighted in the previous session. The next activity in our daily routine will be cleaning our stomach, that is passing stool and urine, and also brushing the teeth. These two activities are to be done after the morning meditation. There is a lot of restrictions in passing stool and urine and brushing our teeth. We are not going to go into great detail into them because most of us may not be able to follow those, but we will get a small introduction on that. It is suggested in Shastram that we pass stool and urine outside our home, not inside our home. It has become a practice commonly that we have our bathroom and toilets inside the homes, but it is recommended in Shastram that it should be outside. And also, after passing stool and urine, one should wash their hands, feet, and rinse their mouth. After that, one should also perform achamanam to purify oneself. Same thing applies to brushing the teeth also. And one should have their head covered while passing stool, urine, and also while brushing the teeth. There are many other restrictions as well, but we won't go into the detail as said before. After this, one will go to take bath. Bathing is not just a activity to cleanse one's body, but it is actually a ritual, an anushtanam. It must be done with that thought process. Our body is made of panchabhutams. So whatever defects are there in panchabhutam, because that is also matter, the same defect will be present in body. That is, after a short while, after some time, after even taking bath, after a little while, body will accumulate sweat, dirt, and so on. So it must be cleansed properly, especially after waking up in the morning. We serve Bhagavan through our body, so we should present the body in the best possible way to Bhagavan. Our body is given by Bhagavan so that we can serve him even while living in this world. So the body must be cared properly to serve Bhagavan. It must be purified as recommended in Shastram. For example, while bathing, head bath is always recommended and mandated for men. any man should take head bath, full bath, to purify oneself. Sometimes we see people don't pour water onto the head and just limit it to the body, but that is not full purification. Similarly, in Shastram, it is recommended that one takes bath in running water such as river. If that is not possible, at least one should take bath in a lake or a temple tank or a pond. Even if that is not possible, one can take bath from a well water. But nowadays, we are even far from those things. We are restricted to bathing in our bathroom. Even in that case, one should follow certain basic principles. We saw how head bath is mandated for men. For women, there are some exceptions on head bath, because they may have very lengthy hair, in which case they may not be able to have full head bath every day. So there are some exceptions. Similarly, the bathing should be done in Arunodayam, that is the time before sunrise. We have seen how in Brahma Muhurtam we meditate upon Bhagavan Sriman Narayana. So after that time, after completing the morning cleansing of the stomach and teeth, the next step should be immediately taking bath. While bathing, we should not bath with the dirty clothes which were worn during the night sleep. One must have a set of bathing clothes which are worn during bathing, and then they are again dried and used on the next day. Also, while bathing, men should always be wearing two vastrams, two cloths, that is lower cloth and upper cloth. They must be wearing both of them. While bathing, one should consider the water to be Sri Pada Tirtham of Bhagavan and Sri Pada Tirtham of Acharya. Sri Pada Tirtham means the water which is used to cleanse the lotus feet of Bhagavan or Acharya. So one must have that bhavam, that attitude, that we are bathing in the sacred water which cleansed Bhagavan's lotus feet, Acharya's lotus feet, and so on. One should also consider the water to be coming from holy rivers, sacred rivers, such as Kaveri, Tamrabharani, and so on, which have connection with Bhagavan and Bhagavatas, Alvars, Acharyas, and so on. One should remember Pasurams such as Gangayil Punidamaya Kaviri Naduvupattu, that is from Tirumalai, Tiruvaranga Perunagarul Tennir Ponni Thiraikkaiyal Adivarida Pallikollum, that is from Perumal Tirumoli, Ilaithalai Charandurandu, that is from Tiruchandavirutham, and then Nindravan Kirtiyum Nil Punalum Nerevengada Porkunnamum, this Pasuram from Ramanujan Uttrandadi. These Pasurams relate to sacred water, sacred rivers, and so on. Hence, one should remember these rivers and these Pasurams and consider the water to be sourced from there, whether it is bathing in a river or a tank or a pond or even at home. We should consider the water to be sourced from these holy rivers, holy places. And one should also think that this water is from Viraja river. Viraja river is the one which separates Sri Vaikuntham and Samsara. when we reach Sri Vaikuntham, we have to first cross this river and then only reach Sri Vaikuntham. So we should think that we are taking bath in Viraja River. And one should also immerse at least 7 times remembering Hari while taking bath. So these are some important principles while taking bath. Subsequent to this, one should wipe off the water, dry oneself, and then wear vastrams. We will see about that in the next session. There are many restrictions actually, but we are only seeing some of the fundamental aspects. As said before, these principles are explained based on what is heard from elders and especially what is given by Kanchipuram Sri Uve Prativadi Bhayankaram Anangaracharya Swami in his Nityanushtana Paddhati Grantham. There may be slight variations in different places. We can inquire with elders and find out further about them. There may also be certain special aspects for those who are having Yajnopavitam. That also can be found out by inquiring from elders. Alvar Emberumanar, G.R. Thiruvadigale Saranam, G.R. Thiruvadigale Saranam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.